On the track here is Gary Niewand, one of Australia's hopes in the men's sprint. Bronze two Olympics ago, silver beaten by the width of a tyre in Barcelona. And can he go one better? He's up against the Frenchman, Frédéric Magnier. And they've had some great battles. Gary won a world sprint title and a Kirin. Magnier is a Kirin rider as well. And Gary's one of the veterans of this Australian track team. Magnier drawing the inside position and must lead for the first lap. Earlier on, Michelle Ferris was very impressive. And she's one heat up in her quarterfinal in a best of three ride.
Bit of a game of cat and mouse here.
Now this isn't best of three at this stage. This is the 1/8 finals in the men. So what we're going for here is to get six winners who will go through to the next round. And the losers, the six losers, will be in 2 3-man heats. But the winner goes straight through. And Gary Niewand, as the fastest qualifier, is the top seed through the elimination rounds. So he's expected to win. It would be a shock if he gets beaten.
And yesterday, watching him ride, he didn't. He won his heat, but it seemed to be with a little bit of difficulty. I don't think he's going as well as what we've seen, but still, it's early days yet. They've got a race every day to get to the final, which is going to be on Sunday.
Long program for the sprinters. Normally the sprint program for the men is over in 3 days, but here in Atlanta they're spreading it over 5 days.
Game of cat and mouse here.
This is where they could stand still if Magnier doesn't want to lead. They've completed a lap.
The commissaire is standing right there. He's got his stopwatch going. This is what the crowd likes. Yep. Commissaire's there with his clock. He's timing them. Says, you guys, there is a limit on this.
What happens is that Magnier wants to be behind. That's the preferred position because you know where your opponent is. Gary also wants to be behind, so he wasn't just going to roll past the Frenchman. Plenty Aussies in the crowd yelling out for Gary Niewand. His family supported him through his career, through three straight Commonwealth Games sprint gold medals and his two prior Olympic programs, and they're here again in Atlanta.
Now I'm interested to see what the commissaire is going to say here. If he says, come on guys, you've got to do another lap, you can't stand there. It's not easy because even now there's a bit of a move. Meunier's moved off a little bit. Now as they move around, it's getting it's a jump. Yep, I think it's taking it pretty seriously.
Well, Gary caught him napping. He's got a long break down the back, but they're a long, long way from home.
Certainly is, and he's pulling away from him. Coming around for the lap. Oh, this is great.
Well, Magnier can't catch him from there. Gary Niewand caught the Frenchman napping. See you later.
Up the track. He's trying to get him to come underneath. Oh, geez, good showmanship there.
That was all over, two laps from home. Well done, Gary Niewand. Brilliant stuff, and the Australians in the stand waving flags, cheering Gary on. There they are. And it was a pretty ordinary ride by Gary, and he admitted it yesterday when he spoke to us. He clipped wheels with his opponent, nearly fell, nearly lost the race, but that was daylight second.
That's right. I think Gary has said, well, enough of this standing still. I don't want to fuck around with you anymore. I'm out of here.